Atrial fibrillation is a condition. It's actually the most common arrhythmia in the world, where the top chambers of the heart, called atria, start beating erratically. A normal heart, the top chamber beats around 60 to 90 beats per minute, whereas in atrial fibrillation, the atria start beating at over 500 beats per minute. It's a condition that leads to increased risk of stroke and causal potential for heart failure and other types of arrhythmias. So a patient, if they think they have atrial fibrillation, they can see any doctor. They should start running with their primary care physician, who, if they do suspect that, they will send to a cardiologist or a cardiac electrophysiologist for further evaluation and treatment. It's something that should not be ignored, as it can lead to serious symptoms and serious, adverse effects. So if they do suspect it at all, their physician would refer them probably to a cardiologist or an electrophysiologist, and then we would do further testing in terms of monitoring, EKG, potentially an echocardiogram, also known as an ultrasound of the heart, to evaluate the heart function, giving long-term monitors that patients may have to wear for over a month. Occasionally, we may end up putting a device called a loop recorder, which is basically inserted subcutaneously beneath the surface of the skin, which stays in for over about 3 years duration. And that can lead to further diagnosis of any type of heart arrhythmias, particularly atrial fibrillation.